Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and we're only about a month away from seeing iOS 16 for the first time. On June 6th, we have the Worldwide Developer Conference where Apple will show off iOS 16, iPadOS 16, WatchOS 9, macOS 13, and maybe a few surprises. And so we'll have our first beta version on June 6th as well, and I think it's going to be a better update than we think. So far, there has been very few leaks, which can only mean one of two things. It either means iOS 16 isn't a big update, or that iOS 16 updates have been kept so secret this year that very little information has leaked out about it. I think it's actually the second thing, where they've actually kept it secret better than they have in the past. A little while ago, Tim Cook was speaking out saying he really wanted to keep things more secret, that they were going to really push to keep things secret within the company, and I think they've done a pretty good job of that with certain leaks. Many people thought we'd see a squared off Apple Watch this past year. We didn't see that, so hopefully they've done the same with iOS 16. Now here's what we know so far according to Mark Gurman. So far, he said that they're going to get some updates with the Notification Center, meaning maybe more customization, better grouping, maybe we can have it similar to what Android has, but a little bit better. I've always actually liked iOS notifications a little bit better, how they're spaced and how they look, but either way, maybe we'll get some more customization with that. Mark Gurman also said to expect updates to health and activity. But that is really not enough for a whole iOS update. At this point, two different apps or three different apps with updates just doesn't make sense that that's all they would do. So I think Apple's kept it very under wraps and we just don't know yet. Now with iOS 15, many people think of this as a small update where in fact it has almost the combination of the last two versions as far as the amount of features in it as what they had with iOS 13 and 14 combined. That's how many changes are in iOS 15. So in iOS 15 though, there aren't a whole lot of standout features, but rather small updates and refinements. The major standout features were SharePlay and Universal Control on iPad, but we didn't even have those at the launch of iOS 15. Now some of this has to do with people working at home, of course, but a lot of small refinements are throughout. So everything from SharePlay, as you can see here, to different FaceTime updates, to messages in Memoji, and on and on. There are so many small updates, it took a 40-minute video in order to cover all of them. So there's a ton of little refinements, but not really anything memorable. But if all of the rumors so far are true, maybe this is just a stability update and Apple is really focusing on that. So making everything stable, and I think most people would be pretty happy with that, but also be very bored if that's all they had. So I expect more than that. Now, as far as the supported devices this year, it looks like we're going to have them dropping the iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, and original iPhone SE. Now, we don't know that 100% yet. Apple has not come out and said that officially. I've seen some other videos say that that's definitely what's happening. So far, at this point, we don't know that 100%. But the iPhone SE, 6S, and 6S Plus make a lot of sense to drop. They've been supported for a very long time, and supporting the iPhone 7 and newer seems to make a lot of sense. They would also drop support for the iPad Air 2 or other devices like that. That makes a lot of sense to me, but again, maybe Apple could extend that. We don't know that officially just yet, but that's what seems most likely. So if this is just a stability update, I think many people would be disappointed, but I think there's going to be some refinements, definitely some additional widgets or refinements to widgets where they're interactive finally. I also think at this point, there's no excuse that we don't have an always-on display. There's no reason we can't have that, similar to what Android has on just about every Android phone at this point. You have an always-on display since we have OLED phones. You could do this all the way back to the iPhone 10, where we could have an always-on display with some additional information. So with Android, you can do that now. There's no reason you can't do that on an iPhone since they're also using Samsung panels and similar technology. So you could do this. It doesn't attribute to any real battery drain since it's very low power, it's fairly dim, and also even on a nightside or a bedside stand, it's very nice to have on just like this. So it's great to have the additional information, maybe have the weather and some notifications if you're looking for those. There's really no reason we shouldn't see that at this point. If we don't have something like that with iOS 16, I would be very, very disappointed. I also expect Apple to do more customization with things such as Control Center. I think this could be cleaned up a bit and also maybe have a landscape mode or something that gives us landscape back, as we don't really have that anymore with the current iPhones. We had that with the iPhone 6 Plus, 6S Plus, 7 Plus, and 8 Plus, and they kind of took it away when we switched to the OLED phones. There's no reason we couldn't have that, and a recent concept shows what that could look like. So there's a recent concept by Apple Lab that shows what some of those advanced features such as landscape mode could look like on an iPhone. So a new landscape mode could look just like this. Makes a lot of sense. There's no reason they couldn't do that. And then updated control center that similarly is good, where it has additional features, maybe the ability to turn off Wi-Fi 100%, and just more and more as far as that goes with an always on display. So just like this, like I said, with an always on display, this concept has some great ideas with the control center, notifications, Apple Wallet, and more. So I'll leave a link to this in the description if you want to check it out. I would be very surprised if we don't at least see some enhancements to widgets, maybe some additional enhancements to icons as well. While I don't expect a 100% redesign with iOS 16, at this point, I think it makes sense to bring these up to speed with what we have with macOS. So they did that recently with some iWork apps. So if we take a look at maybe Pages or Numbers or Keynote, Keynote looks just like the one that we have on the Mac for the most part now. It makes sense that we would have consistency across not only iPhone, but Mac and iPad as well. With iPadOS 16, this is where I think we could see some major enhancements. And there's some proof showing that maybe we could see some things coming very soon. Now, iPads right now have a ton of power and currently feel very underutilized. With this iPad Air and the latest iPad Pro having an M1 chipset in it, we basically have all the capabilities of an iPad and a Mac combined into a smaller form factor. There's no reason we can't have Pro apps on it. So I do think we'll see maybe Final Cut Pro and a Logic Pro this time around to make the Pro devices actually Pro, or even the iPad Air Pro. And then also, there's a recent patent that was uncovered that shows the iPad docking into something such as a MacBook keyboard that would give it a Mac-like interface. There's no reason Apple couldn't do this and make your iPad a true all-in-one computer and then switch to a Mac-style interface if you wanted to edit a video with it with Final Cut Pro. There's no reason for that at this point that they couldn't do it. We have up to 16 gigs of RAM. Maybe you could have more in a future Pro. And we even have an incredible display on the Pro with the mini LED display. We have all of the latest technology in an iPad, and it makes a lot of sense that maybe with the smart connector, we could have an all-in-one Mac and iPad on the go. Apple is really good at getting these things right. And if we have a tablet experience and a Mac experience, and I know that's something Microsoft has done with the Surface, I think it makes a lot of sense on the iPad. We also could really benefit from additional customization. With different apps, we've got a huge gap here. We have widgets that don't make a lot of sense where we put them. The interface just feels disconnected. And at this point, if you're going for the iPad Air or the iPad Pro, there's no reason the Pro is really Pro other than its display and speakers. So at this point, I think it makes a lot of sense for Apple to have a major revamp of iPadOS 16 with some enhancements maybe to multitasking and maybe even mode switching. I would definitely welcome that. Now, the real question at this point is how many updates or changes do we really need to make us happy with the next version to feel like it's a big update? We haven't had a major redesign since 2013, and it makes a lot of sense that Apple could redesign some of this to be more consistent, maybe use up additional screen space here where we have a huge gap at the bottom, maybe let us get rid of the dock altogether if we don't like this and just have a huge grid of icons, or just have some enhanced widgets with interactive controls on them as well. All of these things I think would make it feel very fresh, and at this point, I'm expecting it will be better than we think just because we haven't heard a lot about it. And the software department does not have to manufacture any additional devices, so those leaks can't get out through the supply chain, such as the iPhone 14 can. So I'm really hoping for something big, some big changes, and of course we'll know on June 6th when Apple announces it to the world. As far as WWDC 2022, you can watch it at the same time I can on June 6th at 1 p.m. Eastern time, or usually 10 a.m. Pacific time, and it's on apple.com or YouTube. Normally you can watch them there, and of course I'll have videos about all of the new features and changes after that. Now, if you think Apple's going to make a big change or not make a big change and just some small changes, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. One of the reasons I made this video is iOS 15 has had some very small updates this time around. It makes me think they're getting ready for something completely different and they don't want to show a whole lot right now. So that's one of the major reasons I've thought probably iOS 16 will be better than we think. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.